This is Project Management for You.
Are you a solopreneur, individual, or small business owner who struggles with ideas and lacks converting those ideas into reality?
Do you underpromise,
afraid you won't deliver?
Learn the least you need to know to start your path of turning ideas into reality and delivering on your promises.
Each episode is designed to help you get things done.
Welcome to Project Management for You with Caesar Abade.
Well, hello everyone, and welcome to the seventh episode of the Project Management for You podcast series. I am Caesar Abade, your host, and it is great to have you here once again. On this show, I bring you my conversations with the best project managers I know as we try to break down and explain project management to you so you too can start turning your ideas into reality, delivering on your promises, and getting things done. Now, this is the way that the business world does it. It's not guesswork. It's tried and true. Now, using my own experience as a project manager and being in project management for over 10 years, and also borrowing from a lot of the insights I'm gathering here with this series, I am writing a book called Project Management for You. And if you've been listening to the show, you know all about that by now. Well, as this series airs, be sure to visit projectmanagementforyou.com to check out the crowdfunding campaign I'm running to help me with the costs of self-publishing. And this campaign is going to run for most of the month of October, ending on November 1st, 2014. So if you're listening during this time, I'd really appreciate your support. Many of you has supported me already in that campaign, and I thank you for that. If you're interested in learning more, just visit projectmanagementforyou.com for more details. Now, today I bring you the dynamic Adriana Girdler, and we'll break down project management and explain it to you. Adriana Girdler is one of Canada's foremost business efficiency and project experts. Armed with a Lean Six Sigma Black Belt, Project Management Designation PMP, and over 20 years of experience in project efficiency and process improvement methodologies, she launched her company called Cornerstone Dynamics in 2008. Adriana has worked in various industries, including pharmaceutical, education, nuclear, and natural resources, just to name a few, leading companies to improve what they do, how they do it, and their bottom line. Adriana is an entrepreneur, executive coach, professional speaker, facilitator, and author of Efficiency Matters and Spark Shift book series about productivity, empowerment, and efficiency. She has been featured nationally here in Canada in the Globe and Mail paper on 680 News Radio and published in numerous industry and association magazines throughout North America. Adriana is passionate about improvement and efficiency in both people and organizations.
Today's special guest and project manager extraordinaire is up next.
Hello, Adriana. How are you?
I'm fine, Caesar. How are you?
I'm doing well. It's good to talk to you again. We met in person for the first time a few months ago when I stopped by and we had a cup of tea there at your office. So, and you are doing some fantastic work as a project manager and in project management, and you have a blog, you're on social media, you're doing some great, great work, and you have good ideas and opinions about this topic. So I thought you'd be a perfect guest to be here today. So thank you.
Well, thank you. I really appreciate it. It was great finally meeting you live after all the tweets we've gone through.
I know. There's the lyrics to a song right there.
Exactly.
I'm gonna write that down right now. Who knows? Might be the next big hit. After all these tweets, we finally meet.
Exactly.
Thing. Very cool. So, Adriana, as I said, you are a project manager. You are neck deep in the industry. You do that for a living. You're an efficiency expert. So how would you describe project management or define project management to the layperson?
You know, it's a great question. And I'm really glad that you're asking it, because I think everybody has a different definition. And project management, what I see over and over again when I go into organizations with my own company is that a lot of people don't think of project management as a skill set and a set of tools. And that's how I define project management. It truly is a skill set. It's a lot of discipline, and there's techniques and tools. So project management, using those skill set and tools, is really a discipline that allows for someone to organize a short-term activity, and that short-term activity could be a few weeks or a few months or a few years, depending upon the complexity of it, from a concept idea to an actual execution and the implementation of it. So it says over this period of time, that's what project management is about executing these ideas over a period of time using a very specific tools and a skill set that's needed to ensure success. Mm-hmm. How's that for an answer?
That's perfect. Because I can, I know there's going to be a lot of people listening to this right now who have an idea in their mind. They have an idea maybe for a service, for a product, or they have a small business and they want to, I don't know, they want to move into a new space, or they want to hire someone, or they want to start a new line of services and products. And all these things are projects. And
I
find that sometimes, and I was there too, we feel intimidated by the complexity of things. So what is the least people need to know about project management to start on this path of turning these ideas into reality?
Don't assume, I would say, is probably the biggest thing. A lot of times people assume that you know everything or that you have things in place. But project management, as I said just a few moments ago, it is about a skill set and it is about certain tools. So when you assume, you then don't go through the actual tools needed to unearth things. Because project management is about getting all the details. The devil's in the details. A really well-run project looks easy on the outside. So if anything, if anyone is going into a project, whether it's a project or, as you mentioned, when you said product or service, I know a lot of people who do brand planning, and that's project management, in my opinion. You know, it is, don't assume, look at all the details, and that is so critical for your success. So I would say, you know, if you're going to do anything, is be detailed and don't assume everybody knows what they're going to do. Really lay it out for people, because when you're the project manager, that is your job. Your job is to be that common thread amongst everyone and everything, and to give that macro perspective to ensure success. Mm-hmm.
So when you're looking at a project and you decide, okay, we need to break this down into smaller parts, then are you saying we should just be as detailed as possible and try to cover every single aspect of every single part of this project and have that documented somewhere so we can make sure nothing is left behind?
Definitely. I've come across lots of projects where I've had clients bring me in to a project that's already existing. In fact, that was my legacy when I worked for corporations and was a project manager. I was the cleanup crew. So people would start a project and they'd be into it, and then they didn't do their due diligence. They didn't look at the details. It's all about the planning part, right? I mean, you know, if you kind of think about painting a room, it's really easy to get a can of paint and just slap it on the walls. The result immediately may look, wow, what a change, what a difference. But if you took latex paint and you put it on oil paint, it's going to start peeling off, right? It's kind of those details. It's behind the scenes stuff, which is so critical, that I find people forget. Mm-hmm.
All right, so that's an awesome thing to keep in mind, is the complexity. Make sure that we pay attention to details. Do you believe that there are stages besides the front end part where we discuss all the details? But are there stages of bringing an idea to reality? And if there are, what do you think they are?
Definitely. There definitely are stages to any project. Mm-hmm. And as I said, whether that's, as you well said, whether it's a service, whether you're moving, is, and it's actually in line for those people that don't know project management that well. You know, our governing body, PMI, where we get our designations from, they have a kind of the golden book that we all go by. It's called the PMBOK, and they talk about five initial stages. And those stages I find to be true in any scenario. So whether you're, you know, moving offices, that's a project. Whether you're doing something really complex, like installing a brand new manufacturing line and you have multiple machinery, or whether you're marketing a brand new product and it's going to launch, these all, I find the commonality of these stages are all the same. And the first one is initiating, right? It's the ideas themselves. We have an idea. What do we have to do? We need to get everybody on board. You know, the next one is planning. This to me is really critical because the devil's in the details, and I personally spend so much time in the planning stage, which can sometimes go against what corporations want because they want things immediately, right? But it's so critical. If the planning is done really well and the devil of the details, you unearth everything and you see it for what it is. And again, there's so much more to go into from that perspective. It just makes life so much easier. Then there's executing. To me, that's the easy part. I mean, once I got that all ready to rock and roll and everybody knows what they're going to do and they have their task, it's just the execution of it. You start the process of your project. Monitoring and control, again, that's probably the fourth stage that's out there. And that is as things come along, it's called life. Things change. So you're just monitoring and controlling and making sure that you're still within, you know, what you said you were going to do. And then the last one is the closing, which is really important, which is, are you sure that whoever you were delivering the project for, are they happy with it? Has all the training occurred? Is everything sustained well? And did you end everything off to congratulate everybody on what's going on? So that's, I see the traditional stages of project management, the stages that are in any type of project you can do.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's textbook, correct?
It is textbook, but yeah. It's so true. It is true. Like it doesn't matter the complexity. If it's a couple different, they all go through the same thing. Now you may not use the same amount of documentation. Mm-hmm. You may not have as big of a team, right? Depending on the complexity, but you always go through those stages.
Beautiful. Yeah. Sometimes that's what's tested and true. It's the best approach. And this is definitely tested and true.
Oh, gosh, yeah.
To death sometimes.
Yeah.
All right. So as you mentioned there, each one of these stages, you know, let's say planning and executing and monitoring, controlling, closing, initiating, they all, if you go through the textbook, there's a lot of tools, techniques that we can use to help us through those stages. So if you could recommend, and I'm sure you would agree that this is all kind of overwhelming to someone who's starting to think about managing a project and they don't have the training. So,
yeah.
If there is one technique from the project management world that you would recommend to the masses, what would it be, and where can we learn more about it?
I wouldn't say it's a technique. I would say it's a must-do. In our lingo, Caesar, as you know, we call it stakeholder management. So I've seen a lot of projects, big and small, fail because people who were touching the project, who were either the customer, people within the project who were helping execute it, managers of those people, or whomever it may be, we call those stakeholders, people who are invested in, who have invested interest in what's going on. They were not properly communicated with, or expectations were made and assumptions were made and they weren't cleared up. So, I find, yes, you need detail. Yes, you need documentation. Yes, you need discipline. You need a team. You need all that stuff. But you can have all that stuff. But if you're operating in a silo and you're not communicating with all the stakeholders involved, your project will fail no matter how well you plan it. So I think if anything, before you start, make sure you have everybody on board. Make sure they all know the expectations of it. Make sure that, you're constantly in communication. And make sure you know who your stakeholders are. I mean, one of the tools and techniques I use a lot when I start a project, and it's a very good tool you can get on the internet, it's called a SIPOC. And it basically goes through whatever your process is. So a project usually is around a process, whether it's I'm moving one office to another, I'm installing a brand new line, I'm selling a product and doing a launch. That's the process. So you kind of lay out the process, and then you have your inputs and your outputs. And then you see the stakeholder who's involved with those inputs and outputs, and you start mapping that out. So you as a project manager, even if you just did that, you start to see who's really involved in this, and you get all the right people involved. And when they're all involved in the beginning of a project stage, particularly in initiation and in planning, it is amazing how successful your project will be. And to me, that's the biggest thing we forget. We're given a task, we go ahead and run with it, and then we're done it, and then we can't understand why Susie and Bobby in the other department are upset with the things that we did. Wait a minute. You know, I did this project for you. Well, yeah, but you didn't include me. You didn't ask me. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And that's a common problem I see over and over again, is we're not including the right stakeholders and getting their buy-in up front. And we make a lot of assumptions with them. So that, if you want success, get people involved who are going to be touching that process. And a SIPOC is a great tool. And again, you can go on the internet and just type in SIPOC. SIPOC, it's an acronym, and you can do that. And obviously with stakeholder management, communication is critical throughout the whole project. Charters are great. That's another tool. Again, you can look up charters, and it just kind of outlines the expectation around things, and you pass that off to the stakeholders so everybody's on the same page. I've had projects stop because we've done charters and people made assumptions, and as soon as they got the charter, they realized, whoa, this is not what I was thinking. And then we had to renegotiate everything. So, which is great to do that in the beginning and not halfway through a project.
Mm-hmm. So communicate, make sure everybody's on the same page.
Yeah.
And very good.
And manage everybody who's involved in it. And don't assume, because you'll be, if you don't really look at who your stakeholders are, you will miss people. And then those people will be upset because you're going to do something that's really going to impact on them. And you know, it happens to every project manager. We've all done it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Where we've missed a stakeholder because we didn't do the initial work up front, which is kind of my original point, right? It's all about the devil's in the details and don't assume. Like, do all that work up front so that you can ensure the execution part is easy.
Yeah. And the worst thing is when you're ready to cut that ribbon and then you hear someone say something and you start thinking, oh my goodness, this is not what we should be doing.
Yeah, exactly. I've definitely have seen companies go into projects where you're thinking, oh my God, I know you've invested millions of dollars, but you really need to cut this cord and you need to cancel.
Yeah.
But ego gets involved, right? Which is the unfortunate part. So, but as a project manager, that's our job, right?
Yeah.
That's my personal philosophy. It is our job, which is why I say project management, if you're going to do it, and if you're thinking of putting someone on a project, and if it's really a large scale one, really get a professional to do it. It's kind of like an engineer. You wouldn't, get someone who's not an engineer doing engineering work. So why would you, particularly for a complex project, not get a project manager in order to look at it? And if you don't have project managers, yes, there are a lot of skilled people out there who do not have their PMP. Then you need to educate people on the process. It's a process. It's a discipline. There's tons of amazing tools out there.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I find that some people have a natural tendency of being good at managing projects without any training, and usually these people are, they tend to be really successful in life, and you wonder why. It's, well, they have this knack for doing project management. They don't even know what that is, but they know how to do it. But I do believe that if you can study, you can learn, and you can also learn and be good at it, even if you don't have the natural tendency. And that'd be me, I mean, the poster child of that philosophy there. I couldn't really do anything, finish anything. I was unreliable until I ran into project management and really, really changed my life. So that's why I'm passionate about it. That's why I'm doing this.
You're very good at it.
Thank you. Sorry. Okay. So on that note of having, when you mentioned stakeholders, people who are affected by the project, managing projects usually will mean that you're going to have to work with other people at the very least, even if you don't have a team. At least, let's say if you are a solopreneur, at least you need to deal with your clients, and those that they are people too, so let's say, let's say that you do have a team and you want to delegate to other people. What is the best way to know when and what part of the project to pass on to other people? And do you have any tips on how to do that effectively?
Yes, I do. I'm a big collaborator. I really feel success comes through collaboration. And as a project manager, your success is never because of what you do. It's what your team does. And the same is said with failure, right? So it's your job just to keep everybody on track. So, from a project management perspective, during initiating, you get some key stakeholders, usually senior executives, involved to ensure that's all done. But it's in the planning stage. I get everybody involved in my planning stage. That's probably because I do a lot of facilitation, and I've learned with facilitation, one of the golden rules as a facilitator is that you never do the work that the participants can do for themselves, because you need buy-in and ownership. So I've taken that to heart on many things, and it's so true even with the efficiency work that I do. You know, I never do the work that the people themselves can do because you need buy-in and ownership. And it's the same thing with the project. When you have a team, they have to feel like they own it, because as a project manager, as you know, Caesar, we get the joy of managing so many people and processes and budgets and timelines, yet no one officially reports to us.
Yep.
Right? So we have this additional amazing skill set of being able to convince people that the project they're working on with us is critical and that they have to move forward and they have responsibilities with that. Now, it's easier to do when they directly report to you, but as you know, we don't have any direct reports. So how do you do that? I do that through collaboration. So in my planning stage, I actually do a workshop where I, you know, the work breakdown structure, which is a tool that we use in project management, which kind of is like a hierarchy chart, and you can look that up, type in work breakdown structure. And again, you'll find that everywhere on the internet. And I use that tool, that hierarchy tool, to pull out the big bucket areas that we have to work on for the particular scope of the project that we have. And then I also break that down with the team. So I in advance of, I kind of figure out who I need. And there's sometimes in these work breakdown workshops that I do, I find out that I forgot someone, because it comes through all the tasks that there's this other element that's in there, right? So even with all the stakeholder management you can do, doing these additional activities is going to ensure that you really flush or flush everything out. So with that, they come up with all the tasks, they start putting responsibility and timelines. Now I take all this information and I clean it up, right? So like my job is, you know, paper documentation, cleaner up or timeline manager, making sure things aren't overlapping. And again, I take things from a macro perspective. And when I do that and I bring the team in so early at that stage and they're part of that process, it makes life so much easier for everyone. They've already have ownership. They've already agreed. They've come together as a team, even though officially we haven't, you know, had the, you know, team meeting yet, the kickoff, which has everything presented to them, because right now they're part of that planning stage and they're helping me out by planning it out, and they know what's coming down the pike. So it's a beautiful thing to witness, because as soon as you officially kick everything off and you go, here's your charter, here's your project plan, here's your timeline, I cleaned everything up, here's the whole kit and caboodle, they've already been part of the process, and you're just kind of officially launching it off to allow people to go in their, you know, in their different directions in order to do their tasks accordingly. So that's, I love my workshops. I do that probably in a couple, it's about a 2-day workshop that I do. It's very intense, but it is so impactful.
Very good.
Yeah. And I get hired to do that a lot for companies. No, it's true. Like, well, I'll kick it off for them. We'll get the project plan together, and then their project manager will take it over.
Oh, okay. I see. Yeah. I see. Ah, nice. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm all for bringing in an expert and, you know, to help and oversee those parts that, they're really important, especially this. I mean, the work breakdown structure and make sure everybody has a piece of the pie when it comes to work, and something that, as you said, generates buy-in and also excitement around the idea of the project. So,
oh, yeah.
So
project management's cool.
Yeah, it is.
Honestly, it really is cool, because, you know what, you look at things in a way that you wouldn't normally if you're just looking at it from the outside, because you really, you break everything down and you see the intricacies of it. And you then become the expert for this area. And I really, like, I feel as a project manager, it's my job to direct my stakeholders. It's my job to give the executive team, you know, when they want something, I was given the perspective, okay, great, you want this, here's what's going to happen as a result of it. It really is a phenomenal tool, and when it's done well, oh my God, projects are fun, and it really makes things easier, mm-hmm. You know, because what's the ultimate, you know, job we need to do? Be on time, be in budget, you know, make sure you're on in scope, right? Mm-hmm. Like, that's really what we have to do, and I like to have fun while doing it. So if I get all prepped in advance of and get all the hard work done first, the execution of it with the team becomes a joy. It really does. And you know what? You should be whistling at work, and a really well-run project will allow that to happen. And then people get by and they get excited, and then they want to do other things and different things. And then they're like, oh my God, this is so cool. I like working on projects, because, you know, projects are the other half of business. Like, this is my own personal philosophy and belief. you know, one half of the business, you know, it's kind of broken up into two streams. It's your product offerings, it's your service offerings. And, you know, you have to do the daily tasks in order to execute those, even run the office. Like those are your kind of, they're just, you know, it's kind of like a line that's just kind of producing something, right? Like it's a given that's going to happen. You have my service, I have my products, I have the daily runnings of the office that have to happen. Well, what happens on the other side are projects to improve your products, to improve your services, to improve your business, to make it go larger. So that's how I see business usually set up. So, projects are about improving. I never saw a project that was implemented to become worse. Yeah, that may have been the outcome because it wasn't planned properly, but it was always in the spirit of we're going to be better because of this, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So that's why it's so critical.
Yeah. And I find that businesses, they usually get started because they're really good at let's say, building a widget, and mm-hmm. they know how to do that. And so they just decide, hey, let's do a thousand of these widgets and ship them off. So they mastered the art of doing that one thing, while project is the art of the art of doing something new.
Yeah.
So if you mastered that as well, then really that's when your business can grow, because now you can do widget number two and widget number three, and now you're doing different things, and that's how you move forward.
Yeah, and you're doing them well in a way that's actually moving you forward, versus, as we know, projects that fail cause a lot of stress for people, for the process itself, and then how can you grow as a company, mm-hmm. right? Like, to me, project management is it's a key strategic element of any organization. So it really surprises me when I come across companies who don't have a high regard for project management. I'm like, are you serious? Like, you're totally missing the boat on this. You know, project management is going to get you to the next level, because you may have all the ideas you want, senior executive, but how are you going to execute it in a way that's going to be smooth and streamlined? You know, you just can't give it to anybody. You know, not everybody has the aptitude and the discipline. I think the discipline is critical. Like when I'm on a project, it's amazing the amount of hours I put in just ensuring that the detail is there, because the devil's in the detail, right? A really well-run project looks easy, but it looks easy because all the details have been looked at, right? And highlighted and brought to forth. And, you know, in essence, I kind of, like being a female, kind of call myself, I'm the mother hen bringing all my chicks in, making sure everyone's okay, you know, right? That whole collaboration. And if everyone has what they need, they can execute their stuff. And then, you know, and it's a beautiful thing to watch, right? Mm. So
very good. Yeah, I agree. That's a good comparison there. Now, Adriana, do you have a final thought for the listener right now who wants to learn and use project management to get things done, or to turn that idea into reality, or to just, you know, move forward in life?
Well, you know what? First and foremost is congratulations to anybody who's listening to this who is not officially a project manager. The fact that you're listening to this is you're already ahead of the game, because you recognize that there's an additional education that needs to happen in order to do this successfully. So that to me is like, kudos to you, pat on the back, congratulations. You know, education is critical. Education is critical. I think the biggest advice is your team is your success. So if your team is humming and doing really well, and you have, and your job is to remove roadblocks for them, you know, from a high level perspective, then, you know, think of it along that lines. Right, with project management, give them what they need. So get all the documentation and the paperwork, and make sure the stakeholders are all online. Give everybody what they need and allow them to do their job and set them up for success. Because when your team is set up for success, ultimately you and your project will be set up for success.
Beautifully said. Adriana, thank you so much. If people want to learn more about you and what you do, where should they go?
They can visit me on my website. So it's cornerstonedynamics.com. So that's cornerstonedynamics.com. And we have lots of great blogs there. We have lots of great project management blogs, and just lots of tips and tricks, leadership blogs, efficiency blogs, because they all really relate in my opinion. We also have some services too. So if you are interested and you want a little more education, we actually do offer what we call skills clinics on project management and things like that. So always willing to help out anyone who reaches out and would like a few more pieces or golden nuggets. So by all means.
And you're active on Twitter as well, and I recommend
very people. Active on Twitter, yeah.
Very good. Adriana, thank you so much again for your time. I will add a link to your website and your blog on the show notes for this episode, and people can go and check it out there. Thanks again for your time. It's always great to talk to you. Mm-hmm. And maybe next time I'm driving by you on the 401, I'll stop by again and we'll have a cup of coffee.
Caesar, I would welcome that. And thank you so much. It was a pleasure and an honor to speak on your podcast. So thank you again.
Project Management for You, breaking down project management and supplying you with tips, advice, and simple steps to turn your ideas into reality. Learn more at projectmanagementforyou.com.
All right. I hope you enjoyed my conversation with Adriana today. Adriana is lovely to talk with. In fact, we met in person a few months ago. I was driving by Cambridge, Ontario, my way back from Toronto, and I stopped by her office and we had some tea and just talked about project management, and it was a great time. And be sure to visit her website and get in touch with her and follow her on Twitter. She tweets some very interesting things there through her Twitter account, so be sure to do that as well when you go to her website to follow her on Twitter. Now, if you enjoy what you're hearing here and would like to go deeper, maybe get a step-by-step approach to using project management to start turning your ideas into reality and delivering on your promises and getting things done, again, head on over to projectmanagementforyou.com and consider backing this project. A lot of the information I'm gathering here is I'm going to be using as research as I finish writing this book. So again, projectmanagementforyou.com. If you are listening to this episode between, in October, pretty much October 2014, up until November 1st, 2014, you'll be able to back the campaign and help me publish the book. If you are listening to this way into the future, projectmanagementforyou.com will take you to a page where you can actually purchase the book and learn more about this series and get all the show notes for each of the episodes. So that's it for today. Have a great day, and I will talk to you next time. And until then, remember that life is a project and you are the manager. Ciao, ciao.
Thank you for listening.
Tune in next time for more inspiring interviews and key information to help you get things done.
Want to learn more? Go to projectmanagementforyou.com and order Caesar's book, Project Management for You.
Your path of turning ideas into reality starts now.